See, parenting is a very difficult art. That is why I said, unless you are really qualified to be a parent, please do not become a parent. That could be your greatest contribution to this planet. Instead of bringing forth life, which would not only be suffering, but which would contribute to world suffering. So, this whole art of bringing up a child starts before conception. You have to be very clear yourself and your spouse as to what kind of child you want, how should the child be. You must be very clear about it. And you must take sankalpas that the child must be like this, that it must be like this great soul or that great soul, whatever you want, depending on your conditioning, your culture and your belief systems. You have complete freedom. Now depending on that, you have got to take sankalpas before conception. The moment of conception is very, very important. So that art you must learn. And then what happens in the womb is extremely important. What kind of thoughts you have, your husband has got, and at what stage in the pregnancy, what you are doing, all these things are very, very important. Because your whole life is being controlled by a program. You are only computers. You don't realize that. You are computers. The normal computers do linear processing and your brains do parallel processing. At a much slower speed. The computers are much faster, you are slower, but your advantage is you do parallel processing. And the day computers would do parallel processing, they would become conscious like human beings. So you are nothing but a computer who is being programmed. And your program actually starts before birth. Then the moment of conception, what happens in the womb? That we basically classify into what are called four baskets. Depending on that, it depends upon whether you're going to be successful or a failure in life, whether you're going to be prosperous or poor, whether you're going to be healthy or sick. Everything is more or less determined within those 9 months. Then the moment of delivery is very, very important. As the child is being delivered, who's watching the child, what comments they're making. Suppose in a hospital a child is being delivered, the child happens to be very dark, and a particular doctor there, he does not like dark people, and he would think inside, oh, what a dark child this is. The child would register that. Remember, until the first 6 hours, it is not a child, it's a full-grown adult in the child's body. It thinks and feels like an adult and records like an adult. It is recorded and that stays put until the child grows up and dies. The child could be 120 years, till then it is there. So those, how the child is being received is very important. And the first 6 hours, in the first 6 hours, has the child been touched or not, have nice things been spoken to the child or not, all this matters. So we have separate processes for that. Those of you who are interested, we will help you with that. So the first 6 hours, then the first 6 weeks, 6 months, 6 years, the program closes. This is called primary programming or the most fundamental programming. Herein lies the secret of your life, your longevity, whom you are going to marry, what kind of life you are going to have, a mediocre life or an adventurous life, a great life or a normal life. Everything is determined here. Then between 6 and 12 or 14 is the secondary programming, wherein you put some values into the child, you condition the child, and then between 14 and the rest of your life is generally what you are learning and you are picking up. The primary programming is the most powerful, on which stands the secondary programming, which is not so powerful, and on which stands the tertiary programming, which is not so powerful. These three together are what are controlling your life. Now, if you want to have a real change in your life, we must tamper with the primary programming. The secondary and tertiary are quite easy to handle. Now, to set right your own programming, the best tool you have is inner integrity. If you use that, you will set right your own programming. So before you talk about your child, you must set right your own programming as a very loving mother, as a very kind mother, as a right kind of mother. How? By using the tool of inner integrity. Once you use it, you will know who you are. Then you will know who your child is. Unless you know who you are, you will not know your child. And unless you know who you are, you will not be able to accept yourself. If you cannot accept yourself, you cannot accept your child. Though you think you accept, you really do not accept. That's the problem between you and your child. And if you accept yourself, you love yourself. If you love yourself, you love your child. Once you have discovered love for your child and you start giving that child, whatever be the child's program, that program would get rectified. The child would change. You'll have a wonderful child. So you have to start with yourself.